trying to write the world a safe, sad song.
I'm sorry, I have no idea what you were saying. You know, I was really nervous. The day that I was first going to stage that song with Sydney in rehearsal, which was, you know, three incarnations ago in the show, I was really nervous about that. What was I going to say to her, and how was I going to talk about it? She was 9 at the time, and I started to ask her, you know, do you understand what the song's about? You know, what can we talk about? And she was like, oh, I got it. I know, I get everything about this. And she explained her relationship to the song and identifying with this woman that she's seeing in the diner. And she had it already. She understood everything about it. She's very, very intuitive, very smart, very mature actor, and didn't need to be treated like a kid. And I directed her like I directed everybody else in the cast. I treated her from that moment forward like all the adults, exactly like how I treated everybody else. Yeah, that was the great joy of the show for me. That was the sort of challenge of it that really got me hooked on doing the show. I kept thinking, you know, how in a musical theater, which is an incredibly linear medium, do I do something that is based on a graphic novel, which is built on simultaneity and the juxtaposition of all these images. And that was the real fun of it. And we were, you know, it was really a collaboration with Lisa and Janine, trying to talk to them about what they could give me to do, you know, instead of writing it in, what can we do with the staging to kind of create that juxtaposition and simultaneity. And in terms of the round, it was the best way to do a memory play. It was the best way to find the sort of fluidity of the way the memories came alive in the show. So it made it easier, it made it better, and it made it simpler, and I think simpler is better. I would love to. I can't confirm or deny, though, you know, maybe at 11 o'clock I'll have more help with that person. I'm so sorry.
What advice would you give to your teenage self?
To relax, and things are gonna work out, right?
Directed my favorite play in the last 2 years, I would say, in the Blitz. And you're very busy directing. How do you juggle the number of assignments?
You know, this year was supposed to be a light year for me. I was supposed to direct The Real Thing at the Roundabout and a new play by my collaborator, Bash Horn, at Lincoln Center. And it was supposed to be kind of, I had a baby in September, and I was supposed to kind of stay home with my kid and have a kind of late year. And then Fun Home and The Flick, luckily, were very, very successful and wanted to come back. So I jammed them in, and I took what was supposed to be kind of my year at home and turned it into a year of a lot of work. But I couldn't be more proud to have both those shows running right now. So I busted my butt to make it happen.
Last question.
Started,
did you think that Fun Home was going to have this huge success?
I knew that I connected with the material in a very, very deep way, and I knew that Janine and Lisa were doing something very ambitious, that they had their sights on something very ambitious. And in a certain way, that made me feel like absolutely not. It wouldn't have commercial success, because it was too ambitious to have commercial success. And that's been the thing about this night that is so moving, is that it's a rare moment when something can be artistically ambitious and commercially successful. And I think, knock on wood, that we have that.